Good morning, children. My name is Padmaja. Today I'm going to talk to you regarding food components. Now, what is meant by component? Now, first let me tell you, yesterday I was fasting the whole day. I didn't have any food since morning. I didn't have my breakfast, I didn't have my lunch. Then evening snacks was also not eaten by me. Then I had to eat. Though I had eaten many of the fruits and juices I had, then I had to take dinner after doing some puja and all religious things and all I had to do. And after the completion of all that, only I could have my food. So it was almost very, very late. I didn't have energy at all. In the morning when I got up, then after having my breakfast only, I could energize my body. Now what happened yesterday? I didn't have my food yesterday, so I didn't have energy. So the basic necessity a body needs is food. Water is also essential. Now when we talk about food, now it contains some components. What are the components of food? The components of food are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Now apart from this, we also have roughages and water. Clear, children? Now, what are these carbohydrates, vitamins, minerals, the teacher I'm talking about? Now, when we talk about all these things, let us take an example. We buy so many things in fruit markets or food market we have. We go to many shops, we buy. Now, whenever we buy any food substances, generally what do we find, children? We find that there is a name of the product. Then we also find that there's a green symbol and a red symbol. Nowadays it is put by the government stating that whether it is a vegetarian or a non-vegetarian, isn't it, children? Then apart from that, we also find the ingredients present in it, what products it is made of, the final product. Then also, what else do we find, children? There's a big chart or a small chart and on the product, which tells us that carbohydrates is so much of percent or some 15%, fats is for 20%, and then proteins are of 28%. Don't you find this, children? Yes, we do find in all the food substances, we do find all these food components available on that product. Now, what are these food components? How are they essential to us? What do they do to our body? We are going to learn this, children. Okay? Now, first, when we talk about what is carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals, the first we'll learn about how do we test a food substance, whether it contains the what component does it contain. Is it clear, children? Now let us take an example. We'll do three experiments, children, in which we can find out whether the food substance contains carbohydrates, fats or proteins. Now there are some another components called roughages. What is meant by roughages? Roughages are those substances which help in digestion in our body. Now roughages, for example, we have okra or bhindi, then we have drumstick, we have sweet potato, cooked sweet potato, then rich gourd, all fibrous, of course all the fruits are roughages only. Then few vegetables are roughages, rich gourd, all these food substances, whenever we just, after cooking, when we just press them in our hands, we find fiber-like structure coming into our hands. That fiber helps our body, our food substance to digest easily. So the roughages have to be taken by the human being to see that there's a proper digestion in our body. Clear, children? So is it clear? Roughages is clear to you? Now roughages, now when we talk about fruits and vegetables, we have seen many vegetables. Can you name some vegetables where we peel and use for cooking? Like we use rich gourd, the ribbed gourd or rich gourd, then bottle gourd, sometimes even karela, peel off and then have potato, also peeled and used. Of course, potato skin doesn't contain any fiber. So many of the vegetables are peeled and used. See, children, the peels are also important. You should never ever peel the vegetables and cook for your dishes. You can use directly, but main thing is you need to wash them in a salt water and then use it for cooking.